being stated by various contributors to 92 Kales, its website, and its radio programs are not to be considered as endorsed by A Better Broadcasting Media and A Better Entertainment LLC. Visitors are urged to use their own discernment to draw their own conclusions. We emphasize the importance of keeping an open mind and not construing the data, products, and or services as factual.
Disclaimer. Sir, you on the air. I need you to follow with me. It's Sunday night. Yeah. We dealing with a little bit of this, a little bit of that. We got a whole lot going on. Welcome to the garage apartment. Sports talk, real talk, real life situations with your favorite partners, Right now, we're 1/3 down. We got a man, Mr. The Black Wheel.
One-fourth again, man.
Excuse me, you're right. 1/4, I'd say.
But he's on remote, so he's at JY Education.
We're 1/4 down. Hey, you say what we want. We almost state champions again,
almost.
Hater.
Almost.
Because, you know, last week he was hating. You was talking about how we ain't won this, that, and the other. So we made sure we got back in that thing. Shout out to the Jack Yanks High School basketball team.
Yeah, shout out to him. Good win against Silsby.
Shout out HISD.
We got the tribe in here.
Yay, yay.
And
is
then
that our call, for real?
And then I got one on the side of the road. So out of a courtesy to my man on the side of the road, we're going to let the Black Wheelbond go first. And tell him who you are, man.
It's Ahmad. I'm broadcasting live and direct from the parking lot of Joe Kelly Butler Stadium. ain't nothing going on over here. But there's sports. I don't even know why they got the gate open.
Yo, you know what?
It's a public parking lot.
For your safety, brother. For your safety.
They let me in here, so I'm the only person on the premises, it looks like.
Bus drivers should be making it there.
Yeah.
Bus inspectors.
The buses are not working on Sunday.
Bus inspectors are.
Yeah, they just got the gate open, man. So, I mean, I guess if you do happen to blow a tire on South Main.
Yes, it's a public
parking lot. Somewhere safe to land.
It's open
anyway,
to the community.
That's my story.
Shout out for HSD and our tax dollars.
Yep.
So the rest of you gentlemen, who are you?
My old Mizzle up in here.
Be mad.
Y'all killing me today, but we're going to make it happen. Yes, indeed. And we are here each and every Sunday night from
some of us.
6 to 7. We, because my man is still here. From
in
6
spirit,
to 7
in
Central
spirit.
Standard Time. Be sure to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Man, yeah, the Garage Apartment Media.
Absolutely, the Garage Apartment
Media. Taking over.
We got new content up.
Absolutely, and I told you we're going to continue to be putting new content up. So if you have not subscribed, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're working on some very, very, very special stuff coming soon. So we appreciate the love and the support.
Yeah, we do.
So, fellas, how was y'all's week? Ahmad, I see how yours is starting, but how was your last week?
Yeah, it was okay.
Tiring, man.
You know?
Can't wait to spring break. One more week.
Yeah, that's what you're looking for.
Man.
For some of us, like that matters, I guess.
Countdown like that.
Man, we've been counting down since January.
I mean, I guess, though. It makes sense because I think I have self-consciously, too. Where do we start, man? We have baseball, we had some record-setting contracts signed.
And we had an owner beating up on his wife.
We had a CEO. He's not quite the owner.
I mean, he wasn't quite beating
the CEO of the San Francisco Giants.
He dragged her.
I don't know how to
say
his last name. It's.
It don't matter. It's.
I'm not sure how to pronounce it either. We all know, though, it's the Giants.
What, Larry Bear?
Yeah, we go. Larry Bear. Larry Bear, CEO of the San Francisco.
As in Bear Medicine?
Yeah, just like that.
Bayer, I thought.
That's Bear.
It's Bear?
It's German.
It's German.
You know, it's people got the Ellis Island, it's just however the dude that processed them wanted to spell it.
It's like, you drag your wife, you can come in.
Yep.
So now, for those of you who don't know, yes, the CEO.
Larry, a pimp named Slickback Bear.
There you go. Larry Bear, CEO of the San Francisco Giants, was videotaped in a domestic altercation with his wife.
Drug that guy.
Yeah.
And yeah, he can be seen grabbing his wife by the head, the hair,
pulling her out of her chair
and... That's as much as I saw. I don't know what happened after that. And then it cuts to him walking away telling somebody something. So I don't know.
He did a statement.
He's like, do not sign.
Do not
Bryce
sign.
Harper.
If I'm not mistaken, they're getting divorced though, right?
I would after that, yes.
Or they were already like in the process of getting divorced or something. And they were in some issues over some custody of some kids and stuff.
Oh, so they're married, but they're really separated? Like, they're not fooling with each other?
Yeah.
Well, there's still passion there, apparently.
Let me...
Is he dragging people?
Is that what we call it, passion, or is that rage?
I guess you gotta care about somebody. Either way, passion can be anger. It can be anything. He still feels very strongly about it, to not walk away from it. I don't know what it's about. Where were they, anyway?
Looked like an award show.
Okay, I was like, wedding reception, where they at?
Yeah, I'm not sure. Just sitting outside. They say, I would like to clarify the events today. My husband and I had an argument in public about which we were quite embarrassed.
All right, Ahmad, I need you to go mute, brother.
I'm going on mute.
I took his cell phone. He wanted it back, and I did not want to give it back. I started to get up out of my chair as I was sitting. It began to tip over. Due to an injury I sustained in my foot 3 days prior to my husband beat me up. That's not in the quote.
Don't do that.
My bad. I lost my balance. I did not sustain any injury based on what happened today. Larry and I always have been and still are happily married.
Uh-huh.
That is the statement from Pam. Okay. Pam Bear.
Pam.
The wife
of Larry Bear.
So, ironically, she was already injured 3 days prior to this.
And he broke his foot.
Altercation.
Maybe she's a marathon runner.
And the problem that it is that everybody's saying he threw her out of the chair, but she just came to his defense and said the chair tipped over
when he drugged me.
While he was dragging, grabbing for his phone that she did.
Oh, yeah, well, that makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense for public. And it's not amazing how TMZ can literally get everything up?
Man.
Like,
how they know where you at?
They can't. Everybody can't work for TMZ, so they basically will just come sell.
Yeah, you do,
footage,
because
like,
TMZ buys your What happens is people see something like Larry Bear dragging his wife, and they call TMZ and say, hey, I got video of Larry Bear
dragging
his wife. How much y'all want it for?
And
that's how that happens. So, yeah, we do kind of all work for TMZ. All right? If you catch somebody slipping, you might work for TMZ.
So, that's a good motto. That works by slipping. I'm trying to find his statement.
Keep your phones on and charge, people.
This statement is my bad.
Well, now she just came to his defense. She's doing better. But yeah, that was just a whole crazy situation, man. And so, I wish them the best. Nobody likes to see that out in public.
That's all the baseball we got.
I mean, Bryce Harper got signed to the Phillies. But
all right, there you go.
Nah, we're going to talk about baseball. We're not going to be dismissive towards baseball. Yes.
No, but that's what I'm talking about. The first thing you talk about with baseball.
Well, you know, the salacious stuff always goes first.
No, actually, when it happens to our type people, that's the first thing that pops up.
Highlighting the transgressions as the other man, not just the other man.
So, hey, what they call equal opportunity. You got your 15 minutes, partner.
Okay. I was going to talk about the record-setting contract.
Man, it wasn't
record-setting.
That's
where we're going now.
Why it wasn't record-setting? Somebody just signed for the most money anybody's ever signed.
Man, he only has $25 million.
I need you to go back to mute, sir.
He only got $25 million a year, though.
The record-setting contract was the dude in Colorado.
What you mean he only got $25 million?
When you signed for 13 mil years, bro.
It's really not the math. He didn't get a record.
He still got the most money anybody's ever totaled contract.
Totaled, yes.
That's more money than anybody has ever totaled in a contract. That's a record.
Total, but there's still somebody who makes per year more than
him. Yeah, but that ain't what we based it on.
Why not?
We based it on what he make per year. Because even though he makes more per year, he doesn't make more total.
No. But he makes per year.
What if he only plays 1 year? Does he make more money than the dude who played 13?
For that year,
but
yes.
He has 5 years. He has a 5-year opt out. He might not even make the whole, he might even play the whole 13.
We know he won't play
the whole
13.
I heard he doesn't have an opt out. So now he does have an opt out? It was said he doesn't have an opt out.
Well, I heard he had an opt out.
All I know is Philly is probably going to be in last place.
Machito has an opt out.
Machado,
excuse me.
Wow, did you watch baseball?
You say Machado.
I mean, he played in Baltimore.
Machado.
I didn't actually get a chance to
actually
really see
him. Actually, he played in
L.A. No, he played last year. I'm saying he played the beginning of the year in Baltimore. Before that, he played all his previous years in Baltimore. I didn't get a chance to see him play, like talking about it, till he got to L.A.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I asked. Did you
Baltimore was never on the air.
And nor he should they be.
He was on
right.
the air.
Nor should they be.
He was on the air. Because Machado was cold at third base.
Yes, he was. Listen, him being in Baltimore has nothing to do with his skill set. I'm saying I wasn't able to see him like I was able to see all the other marquee stars because he was in Baltimore. Baltimore rarely was a marquee game, a marketed game.
And because it's baseball.
Well, no, that's not true because Boston and Yankees are on TV everywhere.
That is the problem with baseball.
And I mean, you know,
I know all 20 times they play a year, they act like
Welcome back, Red River
Shootout, New York, Boston.
I know
they play 20 times a year. Stop playing.
And ESPN shows all 19 of them.
I hate
that. God, do that.
They let one go to Fox, so they show ESPN shows 19, and one might come on Fox on Saturday.
Yeah.
I don't know why they think people are that interested into that rivalry. The only people I can't even say the East Coast is that interested. The only people
Dude,
interested
it's called
in that,
East Coast bias.
Right. The only people interested in that is New England and New York. I can't even say the tri-state area because I know people in Philly and all of them don't care nothing about it.
Well, no, the reason they do is because they have fans
they got a lot
everywhere.
Of fans.
They have national, worldwide fans. It's just that they have not been the best baseball in the. They haven't been the best baseball in a while, so that's when it's a problem. If when they were both excellent teams, then it wasn't no problems. You could shove them down the throat. Nobody even realized it. We were just watching baseball. But when they started sucking for a little bit, not sucking maybe, just mediocreness for a little bit.
Who are we talking about sucking?
That's why I changed it. They didn't do the Yankees suck.
The Yankees and the Red Sox?
But the Yankees and the Red Sox.
The Red Sox just won the World Series.
Yes, last year.
Yeah, but there was a, you know. That.
The year before that, they literally lost the most games since the Astros.
No, the year before that, they...
Or 2 years before that. One of those years we won, they were the worst team in baseball. Because Mookie Betts got hurt.
Yeah. I mean, they were still showing 19 of the 20 games on ESPN.
Because...
That's just the problem.
Because ESPN's in Bristol.
Yes, it is. It's in New England.
If it was in Dallas, trust me, they would not get that coverage.
Ahmad, I need you to go mute, brother. You're killing me.
It's a little windy out
what,
there.
I'm in the truck, man.
Breeze, man.
I understand that.
Hey, tell the truck driver what's up. Hey, have him drop you off out here, man.
Yeah, right.
15 mile limit, bro. 15
mile. All right, I'll go on mute until I have something to say.
There we go. Now you're starting to get it. It's just like a conference
whatever.
Call,
y'all need
man.
To hit his truck, man.
matter of fact, interview the truck driver. See what he think about it.
And then let us know when you're done with that. So,
no truck driver cares.
Yeah.
Yeah, please.
We got Bryce Harper, 13 for 330. This shit comes out to like 20 something, right?
25.
We got Manny for 10 and 30 for 300. That's 30 a year.
Uh-huh.
So, I don't know. He got 3 extra years for $30 million. That doesn't add up to... The $30 million a year that Machado was making. I'm just going through what we were talking about earlier. Patrick Corbin signed for,
who?
I know, right? 140.
Who?
Diamondback.
Who?
A Diamondback starting pitcher.
Not even Goldschmidt?
No, Goldschmidt got an extra.
Six
he gave
years,
him an 140. Extra decal. You know, he got traded. Goldschmidt got traded. And so So, you know, he gave them a homeboy discount, a hometown discount, if ever one.
So Keiko still hasn't signed?
No, Keiko
has not.
Could
he be coming back?
He
for very cheap, I hope.
More than likely, that's what it looks like.
Well,
it's gonna happen.
Come on home, brother.
He ain't gonna like it.
I wouldn't either. But you should.
Guess what? I don't like the way he pitches either. So.
Marlon Gonzalez got his 21
honestly,
million for 2 years.
Throw a strike, bro. Dallas Keuchel.
No, it's not how you pitch, bro. Make me throw a strike.
No,
I'm
man.
Painting that corner.
That boy nibbles. He can't get out the fifth inning.
Last year was definitely one of his.
Last year was a bad year
for him.
You know?
But before that, he was Cy Young
was
winner.
Very good. But no, you saw he was declining last year.
Yeah, but I mean,
not declining last year, but the year before.
That's how I think.
He was pitching very scared.
I really think.
Who's declining, Keuchel?
Yes.
I really think he was hurt, man, and he just didn't say anything.
Man,
like he had
his feelings were hurt.
Well, that might be true.
Because he wasn't started. He won the top three.
He was top three.
Not on our.
He started off top three, and then he was poor and then got hurt and then left. But Keuchel is a good pitcher, bro. But he was never. He came out of nowhere in the first place. Like he was a mediocre guy, then he found his rhythm, nibbling, and they were giving him the calls, and he won the Cy Young. And then,
but all our pitchers nibble. I don't like that.
What you? Everybody is not gonna power there, but some people just gonna.
That's pitching.
Yeah,
throwing
it's pitching.
Is just
everybody can't.
Wrong.
Everybody can't throw 100 miles per hour.
You don't have to.
So what you want him to do?
You could throw something that drops.
That's exactly
that
what Keuchel does. He throws a slider that drops so nasty, folks can't hit it.
Man. Right out the strike zone.
He throws something that starts out outside and just stays outside.
Well, last year it did. Before
actually,
that,
I want our pitchers to pitch inside. That's really.
Oh,
I want
you want
to.
Them to give up home runs?
They do give up home runs.
Yes,
what are you talking about?
Because yeah, they throwing it over the plate like you. Want
I didn't
them
say
to.
Over the plate. I said inside. Inside. It could be a ball inside.
Well, if that's the case, they nibbling.
No, just throw inside. Change the eye. Change your vision.
If you are throwing inside, you are nibbling.
No, I didn't say try to throw a strike inside all the time. Just throw inside.
Which means you are
back
nibbling.
Back him off the plate. You could damn near hit the man in the knees. I don't care.
Which means
so
you
just
want to
see some
nibbling.
Movement with his balls.
Yes.
I like how his balls are just straight
if you're gonna,
balls.
If you, he doesn't even come inside. Everything is outside. If you look at his – if you look at his analytics, everything.
I mean, but
outside.
If you honestly look that's at baseball analytics, there is very little coming inside nowadays.
Because inside hitters are opening their hits and opening their hips and hitting the ball a very
hit,
long.
Or you're just hitting someone,
they're hitting
which
the
is
ball
also
a very
a
long way.
Or they're striking out because.
Well, that's all the other hitters. That's all hitters do.
You yeah, you either hitting home out. Runs or you striking out. There ain't hey. No in between no more.
Exactly. So come inside, see what happens.
Nah, he doing
he
right
came
there.
Inside last year. And he got rocked.
When he come inside ball. Last year?
Man, do you not remember?
That man had like 3 walks per inning from first to fifth inning. That is terrible.
And you don't think that's from throwing inside
no,
sometimes?
No, because he didn't throw inside. Adar, you went to enough games. It's all he did not throw
that's
inside.
That's why I'm telling you. I know he threw inside.
No, he did not throw inside.
He's amazing.
Man, I'm telling you, his slider is nasty when it's on. The problem was last year it wasn't on, and his result. I mean his record showed what happens when it doesn't.
So let me ask this, a little bit off topic but right on topic. 13-year contracts.
Yes.
How do we feel about that?
Hey,
I feel it is completely absurd as a organization.
He wants to
give
wants
someone
to stay
a
there.
13 or even a 10-year contract.
He wants to stay there.
Why do you think that's absurd? If you got a player that's committed to staying in one venue for 13 years.
I mean, in the NFL, it'd be absurd, but.
I mean, even in baseball, your skills diminish
they do.
Quite quickly.
No, not nearly as fast as in other sports. Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
No, not nearly as fast. So sign the man to a 5-year deal. When
for
the man's,
what?
How old is
when
he?
The man
how
is
old
32 31. Years old,
yeah.
You think he's going to be
Jesus.
Worth $30 million?
Absolutely.
Well, I'm pretty sure what. You know, there's a buyout at the end, right?
I'm not sure if the buyout is on his end or a player option.
Because that puts him at 45.
Because Machado got a player option. He didn't get. They didn't get it. That ownership didn't get anything from Machado. They gave him a 5-year option and gave him a 10-year, $300 million contract.
Right, well, we've seen 3-year deals before. I mean, A-Rod.
But we have not seen a successful 10-year deal.
Yeah, and A-Rod didn't finish that deal out, did he?
No, he didn't finish that deal out. But Pujols Harper's not going to finish
that
deal.
That's not
out.
Because A-Rod quit. That's because dude.
No, it's
because
you get old.
No.
And you suck.
Remember, he got suspended and all of that other stuff going on during his contract. Not to mention,
but he came back from that.
The Rangers traded him. They could no longer afford the contract. Right?
One person, $250,000.
I mean, why is it absurd for the player?
From a management standpoint, from the organization standpoint,
man,
it is absurd to commit that long to someone knowing that every year their skills will diminish.
Man, because don't forget, like you said, it's a business. If I still got one of the best players in the league or in the world at coming, showing up to my game.
Anaheim is still paying Albert Pujols $25 million. I don't remember the last time he got a hit. Let alone a home run.
What you mean? Last season he hit his 3,000th hit and his 500th home run.
Okay, so that literally could have been the only two hits of the season,
no,
bro.
It's not. It's not. What I'm saying to you all is, stop it, gentlemen.
Or y'all, it could have been one hit.
Y'all are not watching. Y'all are not watching enough baseball. So that listen. Pujols, although it was still not Albert Pujols' numbers.
So I don't even need it. Okay, so say that, because I was going to pull up stats and watch how trash he is.
He still was productive, and when you team him with who they have donned the greatest of all time already, Mr. Mike Trout, who I think is extremely
soon to
overrated.
Soon be a Philadelphia Philly as well.
I believe he's extremely overrated. But anyway.
Oh, he's cold, bro.
He's cold, but he ain't. They making him Jesus Christ on the baseball field.
He ain't cold no more. That's Ohtani now.
Cause now they talking about. They talking about, you know, the fact that Bryce Harper commanded 300. What did he get? 30.
330.
He got $330 million. They're now projecting that Mike Trout will get $400 million.
So what is Mookie Betts gonna get?
It depends who is his agent. Is Scott Burris his agent? If he is, then he expect him to get a lot of money.
Now, see, Bryce Harper could have got a 10-year deal, and that would have been a little more accepting, seeing that he's 26.
He wants to stay in one place.
10 years, he's not going to stay in one place.
He's going to stay in two.
And even if he does, my point is that you're not going to be worth the money.
I mean, nobody's worth that money.
There are several people worth the money.
Nobody's worth that money.
He's worth the money next year.
You're worth what somebody will pay you.
I'm thinking you're worth what somebody pays you.
Yeah, but you're not worth the, no.
No bad
no.
contracts, right?
I was going to say, you're not. That Apple's not even worth what y'all pay.
Wait. We're not talking about
a product. You are.
Carlos Lee getting $330 million. We're talking about Bryce Harper.
Who's only played in one playoff game.
But Trout has not played in any. But like I said, they said he's Jesus Christ on the baseball field.
Yeah, Mike Trout, I don't understand.
My issue is not the 330. My issue is the 13 years.
Well, that's
the man will be
39
at the end of the contract.
Thank you. The only way you're going to get up to $300 million, 300, is if you give them a double-digit year contract. Because they're not going to pay all of that money in 3, 4, 5 years.
I understand every reason why Bryce Harper wants to be known.
I'm talking about management too.
They don't have to pay them.
What you
mean? They don't have to pay them.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
Actually, they don't, because it took a while for him to sign.
They wouldn't have waited this long, number one.
Right.
If you choose not to pay him, then you choose not to pay him.
He was getting scared because he wanted to stay on the West. He really wanted to stay on the West.
Management definitely took a different approach. They took a different approach than they did in past years. But you also got to remember.
I took that $350 million deal in a heartbeat. But go ahead. I'm sorry.
Who was going to offer 3 years?
They said the Dodgers offered him 3 years, $150. But the man wanted 10 years or more.
Right. He wanted 10 years or more. So then then you're saying, why would management do it? Because they wanted Bryce Harper. That's why they did
really,
it.
Really, really bad. Yeah, but
I understand.
I thought baseball was declining.
It's overpaying. No,
we know. We know they're not declining.
No, not this one.
Those are those bogus stats, man.
Turn here.
Regional sports.
I need you to go on mute.
Hold on. I'm trying to direct the driver.
So do that on mute.
And make my points.
Well, then you're going to have to make your points after you get to a designation, sir.
This is crazy.
Yeah, this is getting a little ridiculous right now.
That they get from, like, if you're in Houston, the Houston Astros sports radio station, I mean, TV station or LA or whomever you choose, the amount of money they get from that is raised up every year and will continue to raise up. They're making more from regional money than they ever have. The only thing that's declining is national. But ESPN is still paying $1 billion for the games. Fox is still paying $1 billion.
The game is still very entertaining. And you have very good stars playing the game right now. The reason that you give them that many years is because, number one, the player that you really wanted commanded and demanded that many years. Number two, because you know that once you get this player,
you can't pay for nothing else.
That's not necessarily true.
Who else are they going to pay for?
The Phillies. They have three all-stars. They have three all-star acquisitions they got this year. So now, because you signed your marquee player, your audience is now going to show up. You think them fans not going to show up?
I mean, yes, the fans are going to show up. My issue is that 10 years from now, are the fans still going to show up to see Bryce Harper?
Yes.
Okay, 13 years from now, are the fans going to show up to see Bryce Harper?
If Bryce Harper is still being Bryce Harper.
And that's what he's not going to do. That's what nobody has ever done.
That's what I'm saying. So, right. That's something that nobody has ever done. But what I'm thinking, baseball is a sport where it's a reason that their careers last longer than any other sport. Number one, because they are not taking nowhere near the damage that other sports are taking. Because they do it with, I mean, a lot of people complain about how boring baseball is, but that's because they do a lot of standing around. They're literally standing until the ball is hit their direction, or they're standing at the plate until the ball is thrown their direction. And so, and they're sitting down in between those things happening. And so there, it's a career that is easier to sustain due to the lack of moving.
And I agree with that. Like, in all honesty, I would love for my son to become a left-handed pitcher. Like, all is well there. Baseball is the ideal sport. All I'm saying is nobody, if you're signing them at 27, 30, 27, 28, 29, 30 years old, there's no way that their skills would not have diminished in 10 years. Let alone 13 years. Now, will it still be a lucrative business decision? It might. Will the player still be worth that $30 million that he's going to be getting at 35 years old? I'm going to venture to say probably not.
But what if he is?
Then he's Barry Bonds, and he'll be blackballed out the game anyway.
So, I mean, all of this is on speculation. Contracts being offered, contracts being accepted.
No, this is on name me one 10-year contract that has been successful.
A-Rod was successful.
How?
A-Rod switched teams, but that wasn't due to his doing.
At the last 3 years of A-Rod's career, the Yankees were trying to get rid of him.
Yes.
The man could not hit over 250.
The Yankees didn't offer him a 10-year deal.
No, that's the problem with the 10-year deal. It's guaranteed. It don't matter who offers it. And that's what I'm saying, is that Bryce Harper probably will not be with the Phillies 10 years from now.
But the Phillies,
that's
be
my
paying,
whole
though.
Point.
But the Phillies going to be.
The Phillies will still be paying him.
At least a portion.
It's not
of
a
it.
Bobby Bonilla contract, by all means. So I understand. It's what you have to do to play ball today. All I'm saying
evidently,
is that they wasn't playing ball like that long ago.
Evidently, it was a high risk, high reward. It was one that they were comfortable with making, sir.
And shout out to Bobby Bonilla, man.
All power to you, man.
It was one that they were comfortable with making. And what I'm saying to you is, if anybody could command $330 million, it was Bryce Harper.
Was it really?
Yes, who else?
I can name a few people.
Please do.
Definitely deserves.
Altuve could have commanded.
Altuve, no.
When his contract comes up, if he decides to do that, then that's fine. But right now, his contract not even up.
Anyway.
Yes, anyway.
Kershaw could command it.
Kershaw can't command
a fastball.
Kershaw can't. Up until last season, he couldn't win a playoff game.
I mean, hey.
But has
So what you talking about? Neither can Bryce Harper.
Oh my goodness. Bryce Harper has a lot less effect on the game of a playoff game than a pitcher does.
My point exactly.
Mine too.
So why would you give him $330 million if he has less command?
Okay, let's try this again, because I don't understand why this is so difficult for y'all. Maybe it's because y'all have a bias towards Bryce Harper. So let's look at
no
it this way.
No bias towards Bryce Harper. I actually am a Bryce Harper fan.
He was.
So how are you not understanding
at his,
this?
At his wedding.
I told Gamal and Trey
at his wedding
that Bryce Harper was
going
to be an MVP.
And I definitely said the same thing. Bryce Harper is one of the best hitting left-handers in the game. Just signed to a team that has an extremely short left field wall, which means, of course, you know they're signing him to do what? Hit home runs. They don't want him to do anything else. They definitely didn't sign him for his glove. Now, is he a gold glover? Sure.
Man
is productive.
Because
gets it done.
Because stats say his WAR is terrible.
And stats say because they keep comparing the two. Stats say that Mike Trout is amazing, but
that's
Mike Trout
saying.
Doesn't win a thing.
I mean, neither does Bryce Harper.
Bryce Harper has made it to the playoffs.
So that's winning?
Yes, I'm going to tell you why that's winning in baseball, because they only take four teams. So, yes, if you made the playoffs, that means you did a very good thing. Only take four teams. And it's 30 teams in the league.
Trout made it to the playoffs once.
Trout has not made it to the playoffs.
Yeah, his rookie year.
Trout has not made it to the playoffs.
Yeah, I mean, he made it. His rookie
Trout
year.
Has not made it to
he
the playoffs.
He made it last year, matter of fact.
No, he did not. Mike Trout has never been in the playoffs.
The Angels have never been in the playoffs while Mike Trout's been there.
No, they have not. Mike Trout has never made it to the playoffs. He has only had four winning seasons in his 8 years in the league. He has never made it to the playoffs.
Once
That's
again,
why
we are talking about a team sport, and y'all are killing these guys because one person
is not
winning. When
the man
only gets four bats and only touches the ball maybe twice in the outfield.
No, because the way that they put, please put yourself on mute, sir, and keep it on mute. Keep it on mute.
I'll kill you if you get paid the most, because you are the focus of everything.
It's not even that.
That's who you're building your team around, that person who gets paid the most.
They make it. I told you they make my Mike Trout seem like he can do no wrong.
They say
he is what they call a five tool player, which he. I mean, yes, he is, but. Come on, man. How great are you when you – I mean, if you've only had four winning seasons and you have never made the playoffs, how is it that you seem to be – now they're saying that you could command $400 million. $400 million?
You know what he did last year?
What did he do last year?
Was 312, 40
was
home
Trout?
Runs. This is Mike Trout.
Okay.
312, 40 home runs, and 80 RBI.
Right.
And did not play the entire season.
This is true.
How many games he missed?
The fact that his team can't win, mainly because they're still paying the 10-year contract to Pujols, is not about Mike Trout. You should not think he is less of a player because his team is handcuffed by a bad contract when he continues to put up MVP numbers. The only reason he's not won multiple MVPs in a row is literally because the team sucks.
Right. I'm not disputing it. I'm not saying Mike Trout can't play. What I'm saying is he's not necessarily better than Bryce Harper. And folks are saying that he is. Now, and granted, contracts doesn't necessarily mean you're better than a player either. So even if he does command $400 million, I guess that's not still saying he's better than Bryce Harper. They always compare the two because they came into the league around the same time. They both won Rookie of the Year the same year. Mike Trout has won two MVPs. Bryce Harper has won one.
Both in the outfield.
Both in the outfield. One is in the left. One is in the right. Yes, both hit for power. Mike Trout is more of a threat on the bases. Mike Trout might be a better defender. But yes, they both are extremely talented, very good players. If you as an organization have an opportunity to get a star player, and he is demanding that he get a long-term deal, one that will sum upwards of $300 million, in order for it to be more feasible for you to afford to give him that, yeah, you got to give him a lengthy contract. And so that's exactly what they did, because they anticipate him being able to sustain his level.
Are we talking about?
No. That is not. No. That is not what you stated.
You now you're going to go into something different. The reason they gave him 13 years,
I said these
is
are
so
all projections.
It's affordable for them. It is not on the fact that he's going to sustain his current level, because that's not the case. What they're thinking is that he probably won't drop down to just be garbage, and he'll still be suitable to where we can put him in the starting lineup every day. But it is only because it is more affordable to stretch it out for 13
years. That's what I said the very first thing.
I understand. And what I'm saying is that my whole point is that the player is not going to be worth that money. I don't care if it's more affordable. It's not more affordable 10 years from now.
We don't know that to be true. We don't know that
to be true. It's more affordable for you now. But when the player is worth 19 and you're paying 30 for him 10 years from now,
what if he outplays his contract?
It's no longer affordable.
What if he outplays his contract?
You can't outplay your contract.
I'm saying, what if
a 13-year contract?
What if he plays above his contract?
Then he's the greatest baseball player ever.
Outplay a 13-year.
Why you can't?
300.
Why you can't? Barry Bonds was hitting 70 home runs in his 40s.
And Barry Bonds is taking steroids.
Okay, be that
as yeah, I know. That won't happen again because they test hardcore.
Legally,
right.
You will not be able to sustain that.
That's what they
won't happen anymore.
Look, that's what they want y'all to think. You crazy if you think these boys still ain't
Barry
on steroids. Have you seen
Barry Bonds increased?
Have you seen the way that these boys are spinning this ball? Why do you think all of a sudden these pitchers are getting more and more perfect games, more and more no hitters? It ain't because pitchers got great.
Because they're swinging and missing.
Yep, a lot of swinging and missing.
Nobody,
a lot of people.
Nobody's hitting for base.
Want to be Barry Bonds.
Nobody's hitting for base average.
And why is the velocity on pitches going up?
I mean, well, that's better technique. That's all kind of stuff.
Yeah, well, kids get stronger, faster,
and better.
Your kid's going to be stronger than you.
Perhaps, maybe, one day.
I'm just saying.
Maybe one day. Anywho, you're listening to the Garage Apartment, man.
Better 249 last year.
We're here. Who is that better 249?
Bryce Harper.
That's what I'm saying. I'm looking at the top 50.
That was just a bad year, bro.
I'm saying he had a bad year.
I'm looking at the top 50 from last year. He's nowhere on here.
He had a bad year. Wasn't he hurt last year too?
On and off. Year before that, the man has only had Bryce, baby. Well, he's an RBI machine though. He's only hit over 300 though, one time or two times in his career.
Like you said, it's a new game. Either you hitting home runs or you're not. But what did they get him for? They got him to hit home runs and to drive in runs. And what does he do?
They got him to bring the people back to the Philly game.
All of that is true. So now, all of that is exactly why you give him 13 years on a multi-year deal.
He better do something, because hey, if he can't beat Atlanta, Miami, or the Mets.
Looking at these stats.
Man, he's on a much better team. He now has Andrew McCutchen with him. He has
McCutchen played for the Yankees and didn't do anything.
So this man would literally have to hit 330, up 50-plus home runs.
Mookie Betts
was
hurt.
120 to live out this contract. The highest paid player in the Major League.
Mookie Betts was hurt last year.
Mookie Betts was not hurt.
Yes, he was. He only played 136 games. Mookie Betts was hurt last year.
Okay.
Batted 346.
Okay. And he won MVP. That's right. Okay. He was the man last year. What are you saying?
That man commands anything for the next year.
Okay, so it's his turn right now. His contract is not up. That's just because you put up a good
year. You can already renegotiate your contract.
Not in baseball. That was another point that I didn't get a chance to go to. Because I don't know if y'all realize it, but I can already tell. Another strike is coming. Because we're dealing with the strongest union in sports. And if y'all haven't heard about how these players are upset with the way that the way the management is handling the negotiations of the contract, one is coming very soon. You can mark it down. A strike in baseball is on the way.
Make it happen. I want to see somebody really do it. Make it happen.
Yeah, I do too.
I don't want to see these people talk about strikes just like football players and basketball players. And then when they come back to it, they'll be like, oh, we didn't get the full. Make it happen.
Baseball did
Make it.
It
happen.
Remember, baseball did it. They canceled the World Series.
They did. They had a hell of a strike.
Don't care because they the strongest union by far.
No, because they could play anywhere.
Right, that has something to do with it. That has a lot to do with it.
They could play anywhere
and command their
money. What do you mean play anywhere?
They could play down south.
Right, go to the Caribbean. They can go
you
play.
You don't make no money.
They could go to Japan. Oh, they make enough money.
Ain't nobody going to Dominican Republic to play.
Man,
they do it doing.
Ain't nobody going down there to play.
They do it for that.
And die in a car accident.
True about that. Are you true about that? They do die down there. They do. Them baseball players do die down there.
I didn't feel anything.
We ain't trying to. We ain't got
That's
no
what
jokes.
Happens. People slam into each other down there.
Yeah, we ain't
there's
no
law
jokes.
And order.
That's straight truth. Though. I know. <Doo-doo-doo>. They really should have law and order about that, man. For real.
Yeah,
for real.
Man. They should. So I don't know. Hey, man. You know what? There's been a lot of baseball. Jesus. Y'all alienated the whole black audience tonight.
I mean, hey, it's time to get black people.
We had literally not talked about baseball.
It's time to get black people in baseball.
And you know what? Most black people be very content with that.
That's terrible. Because
they ain't talked about baseball all year.
Guess what? Like Funky say, they're the most healthiest out of all athletes.
Yeah, they are. We don't want to see health. We want to see people putting it on the line.
And here in the garage department, we talk about every sport, sir.
Sometimes.
No, I understand it. I'm not saying we
Shout
don't.
Shout out to City.
But it's not us talking to each other.
Top
no
of
more.
The table. Another week.
See, exactly. And I can talk about that all day, too, DRC.
Shout out to the Gunners.
Nobody even knows they're at the top of the table. You talking about some chicken?
Top of the table.
What are you talking about?
So, see,
they had their chance, and they didn't do it.
This is our chance to educate. So, let's go, D.
They walking along. That's what's happening. Man.
Let's go, D. We got a few minutes. We're going into our last quarter. Explain to them what you're talking about.
For our American audience, talking about a little soccer, you know what I'm saying? For the rest of the world, talking about football.
Yeah, what about Tyrone Woodley?
Football.
Manchester City, that's the team that I like to support. They're
for the past like 4 years.
Excuse me, sir. They're currently number one.
Past used to be
months.
Chelsea.
Top of the table.
Let's say past 4 months.
Liverpool, who is number two, that's LeBron James's. Well, I guess not LeBron James's team. That's the team that he bought into. It's an American.
Yeah, how? Yeah. What percentage of that did he own?
He's a minority owner. Don't take
so
that
So
was
Usher. With
don't
his 0.6%.
I was going to say so is owner. Usher, right?
And what does that mean?
That means they own something. That's what it means.
They had their chance to go atop of the table, or if they would have won, then they would be number one.
So explain to them what top of the table means.
Top of the table means you're number one in the league. The way that soccer works over there is that you have
– There's no playoffs.
No playoffs. You just play games. You play.
So the regular season is the playoff.
And you win, you get 3 points for the win. If you tie, you get 1 point for the tie. And if you lose, you get zero. The team with the most points at the end of the year is your champion. Simple
and
as that.
So yeah, now, that's how it works. Manchester City is number one. Liverpool, if you really want to get into this.
We getting into it. Let's go.
Liverpool has been quite disappointing past few weeks. There would be the starting off, they were the most highest firepower team, okay?
The Los Angeles Rams, if you will.
Liverpool's got the most offense. They got the most offense capability.
But
is what they were supposed to. But lately they haven't been putting the ball in the net.
But is that EPL or is that Champions League also, though?
What's that?
Champions League, Liverpool is one of the best teams in the world right now.
They are. Just too many draws.
Just too many times, which Arsenal fans would know a lot about.
And Manchester.
About who?
Too many draws.
What you talking about?
Talking about your 26-game winless streak or something?
Well, yeah, there was 26-12-0. What's the problem with that?
26-12-0. 12 would be what for the fans, the non-listeners?
Yeah, 12 draws. Yeah, and
ties.
Okay.
A lot of ties. That's 1 point. If you were to
yeah, that's 1 point. That was 12 points. Okay. Uh huh. Let me see Man City go win this, or Chelsea, whichever team you're down with this year. So,
as I stated,
Man City's got 4 losses, son.
4 losses. Uh-huh. How many times?
They'll never be invincible. They wanted to be invincible last year. Couldn't be invincible. They'll never be invincible. There's 2 invincibles, but 1 that anybody was actually alive to see.
And
all right?
I will let you have that. You can enjoy that.
I enjoy that because that's all I've had in the past 100 years.
That's all you're going to have for a while. So the other teams
are maybe, maybe there. Not. But, you know, maybe
Manchester
I'll go root
United
for I'll go root for Liverpool next year.
That would be whack. There's a United team.
Pop, pop, really pop?
That is really coming on hot and heavy, if you will.
Call your brother.
They started off, how shall I say, poorly.
Who's this?
The Manchester United.
Oh, yeah, well.
With a lot of back stuff going on behind the scenes. Mainly they weren't getting along too well with their coach. Coach
yeah.
goes, a new coach comes in, and they've looked pretty well since then.
Yeah, well, they actually got somebody who gave a damn about the franchise.
Yeah.
They got a former player, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, who was one of my favorite players, who was a non-Arsenal player in the early 2000s. Always enjoyed that young man's play. They had a guy named Jose Mourinho, who's just a problem for everybody. And he goes places, and he's there 2 years, and he wears out his welcome in the third, and he's usually fired by Christmas.
But
everywhere
other,
he goes.
Every other place, and he's literally like every place he's gone, he's out by 3 years. But every
that's
other place he's
his
gone
pattern.
Besides Man United, he has also won
people say, you know what, this
in
dude
the first
is
2 years of his career. So the man was a football genius. Now it seems as if the new players have kind of gotten a little bit too much for him. He's a little bit too much about me. And you can't.
Yeah, I think being called a genius too much will hurt you. Because people get to really believe in that.
I would agree with that.
Yeah, so I think that's what happened to him. You know, his story when he first came with Porto and all that was, this man used to be a school teacher and he worked his way up. Mm-hmm. And now the guy calls himself the great one. So
yeah.
It's okay to be called the great one, but when you call yourself the great one.
Yeah, nobody likes people who gives themselves nicknames.
Nobody, especially your player.
Is not afraid to do it at any point in time. So,
yeah
that's
man.
Just a little bit of English soccer there. You know, there's a lot more soccer out there. MLS has started up. Look for us in some Dynamo content coming soon.
I was going to say,
did yeah.
they win yesterday?
Yeah, we're going to educate
yes.
you on that.
They have advanced from in the, how you say, CONCACAF.
CONCACAF
Champions
League.
League. So.
Which is a pretty big deal. I think people
Tuesday
need to
though.
Know that this is a pretty big deal. What that is exactly is they take all the champions and top teams from leagues all around the world, and they have
no.
just South
no,
America.
No.
Well,
no.
I mean, wait,
leagues
and
CONCACAF.
Technically,
yeah.
he's correct.
No, not all over the world.
No, not all over the world.
There's really 2 countries that really, really hardcore play soccer in CONCACAF, and Mexico and the United States. Costa Rica's got kind of a decent
That doesn't
league.
Mean other countries aren't eligible. Those are just the ones who participate.
We beat a Panamanian
team. Yeah, they're
team.
Eligible, but, I mean, we played Guatemala. We played a Guatemalan team.
Let me finish what I was saying.
That's pretty much
so
semi-pro.
Now.
No, but don't miseducate. It's not all over the world. It's teams in the North America, Caribbean, and Central
so
America.
Simply specify if you're talking about the CONCACAF Champions League.
That's what he's talking
or just
about.
Just Champions League in general. Because if you're explaining the rules, which I thought you were, then you could simply just explain the way the Champions League works. And it works like that in every country.
Being
every
that they take the top teams, the champions and the top teams of leagues from around the world, and they put them in one league and have them play against each other. Would you agree with that, Ahmad?
No, CONCACAF are teams in CONCACAF.
Did I specifically say CONCACAF?
Yes, you did.
No,
that's
I
what
did
the
not.
Dynamo had. Yeah, you, well, that's what you have to be talking about. If you're talking about Dynamo, the Dynamo not in the UEFA Champions League.
Okay, now he has expanded it to the entire Champions League format. Just the
okay,
Champions League
well, yeah,
in general.
I guess, okay.
Fine, let's do it your way, Ahmad, because you know, I'll be honest with you, you getting on my nerves tonight, homie.
I'm sorry, but you're miseducating people. You got people thinking an MLS team is actually beating teams from all over the world.
You know they
when they're beating. When they're beating impoverished people who are trying to get
the
here.
The only people
you
they
know,
beat.
You know, CONCACAF is actually trying to find somebody to sponsor them next year.
Are they? Yeah, yeah, sad.
Garage Apartment.
I was going to say, hey, those of you who out here supporting the Garage Apartment, let's put some money together. Let's become a sponsor of the.
Because whoever was sponsoring that champ, they're not holding it next year.
But
yeah.
It is an excellent concept.
I don't know.
Champions League. I like the way it does. Even though Ahmad feels that every other team outside of America and Mexico is trash, there are some interesting matchups.
On this side of the world, yeah. Now, I'm not talking about when you go to Europe and South America and places like that. But, yeah, pretty much.
But it's basically the same. I mean, you're playing Dynamo Kiev. That's not – they're not going to be able to sustain themselves with a Bayern Munich.
No, but those guys are full professionals. These dudes – these dudes in Guatemala drive a truck during the day and go to soccer practice at night.
Not all of them. There is an elite club.
Yes, the rest of them. The rest of them moving dope.
That does not have to do that. The problem is that we can't get to like the Bocas and the River Plate. Those are
Because they'll never let us in the Copa Libertadores.
They have a South American tournament.
We don't belong there.
For strictly
we don't want to be there
American
either.
Teams, and then they have a North and Central American tournament.
I was going to say Brazil
The South American teams are too good to kind of play with us.
Them Brazilian teams are pretty nasty, bro.
I mean, Mexico was in Copa Libertadores for a couple of years. And
they weren't winning.
They threw them out because Tigres made it to the semifinals and they didn't want a Mexican team to ever win. I'm dead serious. But they brought Mexico in because of the TV money. But then when a Mexican team went in there and damn near won the tournament, South Americans, I don't know if y'all know too much about South Americans, but they have a very high opinion of themselves. And a lot of times they think other people from other countries aren't good enough. So they definitely want a Mexican team to win that title.
Sounds like some North Americans I know.
Yeah, it might be.
Ain't no
South America's pretty rough, man. And that's our soccer talk.
Neymar put out a
statement. I was going to say, well, MLS, I just saw the Galaxy just dropped your boy Dos Santos.
Did they?
Yeah. They needed to.
Yeah.
Because they only brought him in for his brother.
Yeah.
Giovanni was never really wanted to be there. And never really quite produced.
Why not? That's LA, man. Can't get no Mexico, no more Mexican than that.
I mean, you can go to Mexico.
Yeah, you can get way more Mexican than that.
Go home and eat home-cooked meals. And
that's East L.A.,
but
man.
Neymar just put out a quote saying, partying at the club, not holding me back from my individual success at PSG.
Hey.
They caught him out. They caught him out partying.
Neymar is the John Wall of the of
the John Wall.
No, look, he's
is
better.
He Wall?
No, no, not in caliber as in meaning the partying cat, the partying superstar.
He's more James Harden ish.
You would say more James Harden.
He be out there, bro. But he's a fun loving South American kid, Brazilian kid. You know, just out there playing the game, living life,
getting paid.
Like $500 a week, $500,000 a week.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
While Mbappe scoring all the goals,
hey,
though.
But don't worry about that, bro. Mbappe only here because I'm here.
So now here we go, fellas. We got 5 minutes. Where we want to go with this one? That was a little bit of our soccer talk.
Yeah.
You know what? We'll be dabbling here and there. We'll give y'all a little bit more every time. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We got something we're working on very soon called the Garage Apartment. So far this week, we will be doing a midweek show. We will be doing that on our YouTube channel, so be sure to subscribe to that. Be looking out for that. So, NBA, where y'all want to go? NBA.
How about the Rockets?
Man,
how about the Rockets?
How about the Warriors?
How about the Warriors?
You weren't worried about. Three straight.
I'm still not worried
about. Three straight.
Who going to beat them?
Apparently the Rockets.
How is apparently the Rockets going to beat them?
Yeah, the Heat maybe if they move to the West.
Exactly, the Heat.
Stop it, man.
And who
hey, man, this ain't your big brother's Warrior. This is a completely different team.
Warriors.
I don't think they really like each other.
I was going to say, they're, like, my thing is that they are just as cold, if not better.
Matter of fact,
it does seem like there is a lot of tension.
Matter of fact, I don't think, what's your boy Draymond Green? I don't think he's quite vocal in this one. I think
that's his problem. They shouted him down. They were like, all right, we didn't had enough, homie.
Dang right they did.
Yeah, they're like, we didn't had enough.
Kevin
you,
is way
because
better than
truth,
you, son.
Exactly. Truth be told, like, you not, if I got to choose you or Kevin Durant, I'm choosing Kevin Durant. And so I think they basically told him, sit down and shut up, Draymond.
Who's talking about?
You said management.
Oh, I thought you said Boogie told him.
Management came down to
I can see
man,
Boogie
huh?
telling him that.
I think they basically told him, look, if it's going to be out of one of y'all, we taking KD every day.
And did you forget that he has not signed his contract yet, Draymond? I need you to pipe it down a little bit till we put the ink on the paper. Then you can cuss him out all you want.
But see, like I said, in Draymond's mind, you know, they won one before KD, so they, you know, they don't need him. But he's sadly mistaken.
That boy Ahmad Jennings, number one fan of Garage Apartment. Ahmad Jennings says KD is out of there.
Yeah,
he might
be. He's gone.
More than likely.
Where do you think he's going? You think he's going New York?
New York.
Not
who's this?
Him and Kyrie.
KD, he gonna go to New York?
Him, Kyrie, and it's gonna be that boy Knox. And they gonna look good.
They gonna look
good.
They gonna
look
good.
They
gonna
trash.
That's bad English.
They gonna look good.
Very
and then
well
be trash
at the basketball game that they play.
New York, huh?
It depends, man. None of these young kids been able to handle New York.
I was just
going to
say.
To me, that's been the Knicks' problem.
I was just getting ready to say.
Nor LA.
Kevin Durant is
that's
extremely
why not
sensitive.
Getting no young kids. No.
Nor
he is,
LA.
He is extremely sensitive, and yep. and the belly. I mean, the beast that is New York media. Oh
New
my
York media
is going to eat him alive.
Yep.
Nor LA.
Only
they don't handle LA too well.
You're
either.
Not good or successful.
Well,
if
yes,
it's
successful.
Then
he's
it's just
going
to be the tabloids that come for you. In which case, you don't have to read those anyway. But you're Kevin Durant. You're going to be trolling them on Twitter anyway, so you're cool with that. That's what. You
yeah,
do.
I know. But they find stuff to. I mean,
just
you got to. They have MSG Network. They have a network devoted strictly to the Knicks.
Yes, but if they're good,
off season, in season, everything is too much media. They're going to catch everything you do. And yeah. He likes his privacy. He ain't gonna like New York.
If he liked his privacy, he would have stayed in Oklahoma.
Yeah,
he dang sure would have.
So I don't think
he obviously
wants
something.
Yeah, he wanted more
better.
Than that, right? He definitely wanted more than that.
He wanted the ship. He got
no,
that. Now
he
wants something else big and better.
Yeah, he saw the blueprint. He saw the LeBron blueprint. It was like, okay, I'll go get some rings,
so
and then everybody'd be like, man, that's championship winning KD right there. Let's go get him. Let's go get him for our squad. He's gonna make our squad better.
So yeah,
I don't know, man.
He did say that 2 minutes ago. He did say that, and I read in an article that he thought that yes, winning championships was going to solidify his legacy, and he thought that people were going to respond to it much differently.
I think
that issue is more with how he did it.
I know this is off. I know we only got 2 minutes though. I know this is off subject, but. Huge shout out to my uncle Keith Jones. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Yo, you and your wife Kimberly. You can do all that if you want, man, but hey, the man got married.
That's fine.
Hey, 50
but
year
you
could have
did that when we were signing off. We
in
the middle
no,
of something.
No, we signing
oh
off
God,
2 minutes,
man.
Signing off. Every time you say that, we'd be like, "Oh, we off," and then start doing the credits. So I'm getting my uncle the
you
shout
stopped
out right
our
now.
Point.
What is your point?
Nothing now. We talking about Keith.
You're right.
Let's
you
go.
Don't ever have a point. You don't ever have a point. So shout out to Keith. Shout out to Kim. It was a great,
great ceremony.
It was actually funny to see all the old school players. The old school players doing their thing like it was 1986 again. Dog, they were so funny. Yo. They said they went to sleep. What was it, Saturday night? No, Friday night bachelor party. Went to sleep at 9:30. Drunk as I don't know what.
Hold on. 9:30 at night.
9:30 at night.
leave it there, man. This is the Garage Apartment. We are here each and every Sunday night from 6 to 7 Central Standard Time.
Check us out.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. May y'all have a blessed week. Be looking out for our Garage Apartment so far this week show coming real, real soon. Y'all be good. Stay blessed.